preventing another venous thromboembolism, or VTE. If you have had a dangerous blood clot, also known as venous thromboembolism, or VTE, you are very likely to have another one after you stop taking blood thinners or anticoagulants. About half of the people who have had one dangerous blood clot will have another one within 10 years. People who have had a blood clotting problem, cancer, or who cannot move much are even more likely to have another blood clot. If you are taking blood thinners, you should be very careful to avoid hurting yourself. Because blood thinners prevent clotting, even a tiny cut or bruise, which is bleeding under the skin, will bleed a lot more if you are taking blood thinners. Even if you do not have a cut or bruise, a bump or fall could cause you to bleed internally. When taking blood thinners, your body may need help to stop the bleeding. Let your doctor know right away if you notice any signs of unusual bleeding, like bleeding from your gums or nose, blood in your urine or stool, heavier than normal menstrual periods, vomiting or coughing up blood, dizziness or weakness, and/or severe headache or stomach ache. If you have had a dangerous blood clot, you will need to take blood thinners for at least 3 months. Some people need to take these medicines longer, and some people have to take blood thinners forever. When you stop taking blood thinners, you may be told to take an aspirin. It is not as powerful as the other blood thinners, but aspirin cuts down the risk of another blood clot by 33%. You can have another dangerous blood clot even while you are taking blood thinners. About 1 out of every 20 people will have another serious blood clot during the first 3 months they are on blood thinners. If you have ever had a dangerous blood clot, it is important to get up and move regularly. Moving is important whether you are taking blood thinners or not. Don't sit for hours. If you can, get up, move around, and take a walk for at least 30 minutes each day. You can do leg exercises while sitting or in bed. Raise your feet and make ankle circles or flutter your feet. Keep the blood in your legs moving. Compression stockings may be helpful as well, but are not a substitute for blood thinners or activity. Travel can increase the risk of a blood clot developing. If you or someone in your family has had a dangerous blood clot, see your doctor before you take a trip that will require more than 6 hours of sitting. When you take long trips, try to walk up and down the aisle every hour or so if you are flying or in a train. Get out and walk around if you can on layovers or refueling stops. Exercise your calf muscles while sitting in your seat. Drink lots of water and avoid drinking alcohol or taking sleeping aids. And/or ask your doctor about wearing special fitted compression stockings that keep blood from pooling in your legs. If you have had a dangerous blood clot, you are likely to have another one. To cut your risk, take blood thinners or aspirin as your doctor recommends. Avoid sitting for a long time. Walk around or at least move your legs and feet. Get regular exercise. Eat healthy food. Maintain a healthy weight or lose weight if you need to. And if you smoke, it is very important to quit. If you develop any of the warning signs of a serious blood clot, call your doctor or call 911 right away. Being proactive with your health could save your life.